In this video, I'm going to show you 10 amazing chess trap in the Caro-Kann defense for white that you can use to trick your opponents and win more games easily. So let's move on to our first trap. After e4 c6, you play this tricky knight to e2. He goes d5, the usual Caro-Kann. Then you play e5, and after bishop f5, with the idea of playing e6, you just play knight to d4, attacking the bishop. So bishop g6, then you go with this amazing e6, sacrificing this pawn. And here, c5 is the most common move, attacking your knight, but you can play this amazing bishop to b5 check. And he goes knight c6, then you play knight takes c6, and after pawn takes, you play bishop takes c6. And now he is forced to block with the queen. Then you can take this queen with the pawn, and after king moves, you can take the rook as well. And now you are completely winning in just 10 moves. Let's move on to our next trap. After e4 c6, knight f3, he goes d5. Then you play knight c3, and after d takes e4, you recapture. He goes bishop f5. Then you play knight to g3, attacking the bishop. So he goes bishop g6. Then h4. Trying to trap the bishop, so he goes h6, creating an escape square for the bishop. Then you play knight e5, bishop moves back. Then you play this tricky queen to h5, threatening mate in one. So he will go g6. Then you play this amazing move, bishop to c4, sacrificing the queen. He can't take because bishop takes f7 is a checkmate. So he is forced to play e6. But then you can play this amazing queen to e2. Then in this position, queen to e7 is the only move which is good for black, and all of the moves lose for black. For example, he plays bishop g7. You just play knight takes f7, forking the rook and the queen. So king is forced to take, then comes queen takes e6 check, king f8, and then queen f7 is checkmate. Let's move on to our next trap. After e4 c6, knight f3, he goes d5, then e takes d5, and after he recaptures, you play knight to e5. He goes knight c6 with the idea of exchanging knights, but you play d4 supporting this knight. He goes bishop f5 with the idea of playing e6, then you play queen f3 attacking the bishop. Now this bishop cannot take this pawn because queen takes f7 will be a checkmate, so he plays knight takes d4, defending the bishop and attacking the queen, and also threatening a fork on c2. And seems like white is going to lose, but white have this amazing shot, queen takes f5, and you are also defending the threat of c2. So he is forced to capture, but then comes bishop to b5 check, and as you can see, this king have an only-gun move, so he is forced to block with the queen. But then you can take this queen, and after king moves, instead of playing knight takes f7, which is quite okay, but you will lose both your bishop and the knight. Instead, you can play bishop takes f5, and now you are just up 2 pieces and completely winning. Let's move on to our next trap. After e4 c6, knight f3 d5, you take this pawn, and after he recaptures, you play knight e5. And in this position, he plays bishop to f5 with the idea of playing e6, but this was a blunder because of bishop to b5 check. If he blocks with the bishop, then you can play queen to h5, threatening mate in one. So g6, then you play this tricky knight takes d7. If he takes your queen, then comes knight to f6, double check, checkmate. So he takes your knight. But then you can play queen takes d5, putting pressure on this knight, so he can't do much. So he tries knight f6, but then you can take this pawn as well, and you are up 2 pawns and completely winning. And what if in this position he tries to play knight d7? Then you play queen to f3, putting pressure, so he can try bishop e6, but then you can play bishop takes d7. And now, if bishop takes, then queen takes f7 is checkmate, so he plays queen takes d7, but then you can recapture his queen, and you are up a queen and completely winning. And there's one more variation where he plays knight to c6, then you can just take this knight, and after pawn takes, you play bishop takes c6, forking the king and the rook. And after bishop blocks, you can take this rook and you're completely winning. Let's move on to our next trap. After e4 c6 d4, he goes d5, then you play e takes d5, and after c takes d5, you play knight f3, he goes knight c6, then you play c3, and here bishop g4 is a common move, pinning your knight to the queen. But you play bishop to b5, pinning his knight to the king, then he goes e6, normal move, then you play queen a4, putting pressure, so queen c7, and then you play this amazing knight to e5, putting more pressure on this knight and attacking this bishop. So he can't do much, so he plays bishop f5, but then you can take this knight, and after pawn takes, you play bishop takes c6, he goes king e7, and then you can take the rook and your upper rook and completely winning. Let's move on to our next trap. After e4 c6, d4 d5, you play knight c3, he goes d takes e4, then you recapture with the knight. And here he goes knight d7. This is the Karpov variation. Then you play knight g5. And here h6 is the most common move, attacking this knight. But then you can play this amazing knight to e6. And here the best move for black is to play queen b6. Then you can just take his bishop with the knight. And then he takes with the knight. But here the most common move is f takes e6, capturing the knight. But then you can play this amazing queen h5 check. And after g6, queen takes g6 is a checkmate in just 8 moves. Let's move on to our next trap. After e4 c6, d4 d5, you play knight c3. He goes d takes e4, and then you recapture with the knight. He goes knight f6. Then you can just take this knight. And after he takes with the e-pawn, you play bishop c4. He goes bishop e7. Then you play queen h5, threatening mate in one. Castling seems like a natural response. Then you play knight e2. And after g6, attacking your queen, you play queen f3. He goes knight d7, developing the other knight. Then you play bishop h6, attacking the rook. He goes rook e8. And here, every move seems like natural, but you can shock him with this amazing bishop takes f7, sacrificing the bishop. He can't take this bishop because queen to b3 is checkmate, so he is forced to play king h8. But then you can just take his rook, and after he recaptures, you are just up an exchange and completely winning. Let's move on to our next trap. After e4 c6 d4 d5, you play f3. This is the fantasy variation. He plays d takes e4, then you recapture, and e5 is the main line. Then you play knight f3, and after he goes e takes d4, you play bishop c4. He goes knight f6. Then you just castle here, and after bishop c5, you play knight to g5, threatening a fork. So castling seems like a natural response, but you shock him with this crazy knight takes f7. Now he's forced to recapture with the rook, and then you take with the bishop. And after king takes, seems like we have lost two pieces for a rook and a pawn. But it's not over yet because of queen to h5 check, forking the king and the bishop. And also, this knight cannot take because the rook is pinning this knight to the king. So king moves, and then you can take the bishop, and you are up an exchange and completely winning. Let's move on to our next trap. After e4 c6 d4 d5, you play e5. This is the advanced variation. He goes c5, attacking this pawn right away. Then you play c3, and after knight c6, you play knight f3. He goes bishop g4, pinning this knight to the queen. But you play d takes c5, and after knight takes e5, putting more pressure, you play this amazing knight takes e5, sacrificing the queen. He can't do much, so he plays bishop takes d1. Otherwise, he will be up a piece. Then you can play this amazing bishop to b5 check. And after queen blocks, you can take this queen with the bishop. King to d8 is forced, and this is not yet over. Don't go for knight takes f7 right away. First, you are going to take this bishop. And after he plays any other move, say f6, you can then play knight f7 check, and after king takes, You can just take this rook, and now you're completely winning. Let's move on to our next trap. After e4 c6 knight f3 d5, you go with this tricky d3. He goes d takes e4, then you play knight g5. He goes e takes d5, then you recapture with the bishop. And here, knight f6, which immediately loses to knight takes f7, forking the queen and the rook. King takes, then comes bishop g6, discovered attack on the queen, and this king cannot go back. So after king takes or pawn takes, you can just take his queen, and now you are completely winning. Well, this is not the end. If you want to learn some more amazing chess traps like these, then you can check out this left playlist. And if you want to learn some new chess openings, then you can check out this right playlist. And if you don't want to miss the upcoming videos, then don't forget to subscribe.